Hi, my name is Sonjia and this is my channel See It Then See It Now, and this is my first video, so I really appreciate you stopping by to have a watch. I've been crafting for years and I often get asked how I create my projects, so I decided that I would show the process from start to finish. So on this channel you will see upcycling, crafting, furniture flips, room makeovers, and basically anything else I can think of to have a go. For this video, I'm going to transform a boring metal bowl into a beautiful floral arrangement. I got this bowl from the range. I wouldn't normally pick a bowl like this with it being metal. I just walked around measuring everything until I found one that would fit in the space that I needed it to fit in. So I gave it a coat of French Chic Alfresco paint in the colour Smudge, and it covered really, really well. Only needed one coat. I got both of these stencils off of Amazon. I really like both of them and I wasn't really sure which one to use. I just put each one against the bowl to have a look and see what they would look like. I decided against this more square one. I thought it might be difficult to get it to look straight with the bowl being so curved. I thought that this one that I'm using here would be more forgiving. Having said that, I spent ages straightening it up and trying to get it aligned so that it looked nice and straight. Once I was happy with the position and I had it taped on, I used some white acrylic paint and just dabbed it through the stencil. I then used my fingers just to push the stencil down into the curves of the bowl so that I could dab the paint on. It kind of worked, but there were a couple of places where there was a bit too much paint had gone through. The good thing about paint though is it's easy to paint over it and just touch it up. So that's what I did. I was a little bit fussy with this and I did mess with it for a while, touching it up, but once I was happy with it and it was dry, I sealed it with a coat of clear matte varnish. Once the varnish was dry, I cut and wedged in some pieces of floral foam and ready for the flower arrangement. As I mentioned earlier, this arrangement is to go in this very specific place, so I can't come too far up and make it too tall or have it coming over the sides of the bowl too much. These flowers were from an arrangement that I dismantled, which I no longer had a place for, and they were perfect for this because I needed it to be fairly short, and these all had short stems, made it kind of perfect for this arrangement. That and the flowers are really pretty. There's no rhyme or reason to how I do an arrangement. I basically just start putting things where I think they look pretty and just building from that. Once my arrangement looked nice and full, I moved it around and checked it from different angles, just looking for any gaps or for any areas where it looked too compact or where the flowers looked too close together, just to make sure that it was all nice and even. To fill this gap in the arrangement, I just had a look at all the different bits, and I think I just ended up pulling a bit from two different flowers and then taking some leaves just to fill it in. Because sometimes it's difficult when you've got all around, you've got every single different flower all the way around. So you might put some, for example, some white flowers in, but then it looks too much white. And if you put a pink flower in, there's too much pink. So I ended up pulling a bit from one, a bit from another, just to blend it in so it wasn't too much of just one colour, and I think it worked rather well. Now you've seen how I put this together, let's have a look at how it looked at the start and see it then. And let's see it now. If you want to try this for yourself, I've left a list of the products I used in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this transformation, please click the like button and leave me a comment. And if you would like to see more from me, please hit the subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.